Guys, welcome back to another video. I hope you're all well. So today I am going to do a full face look and do a nice coloured eye. So I hope you enjoy, keep watching, and let's just get straight into it. Okay, so just sort of ignore this on top of my head. So let's start off with a primer. So I'm using the NYX HD Studio Primer. So this is brilliant. Helps to keep your foundation in place all day. It's well worth using a primer. So pop it on like this. Don't rub it in, just give it a pattern. And that way it will just sink into your skin better. Just really pat it in. This is a brilliant primer. This is probably my favourite that I've used. I've used quite a few that I haven't got on with. The Rimmel Baby Skin, I think it's called. That's a good one too. I've used that one. But this is my favourite. It just gives such a nice feel to the skin, and foundation really goes on nicely as well. So once that is all patted in, we're going to go in with some foundation. It's my two usual, so the Maybelline Superstay and the Infallible Total Cover L'Oreal. The L'Oreal is in shade Light Sand, so it's slightly darker. Maybelline is in, I think, light beige. So I bought this and it was too light, and I bought this and it was too dark. Mix them together and they're just perfect. So, okay, so wet beauty blender. And let's start on our face. Remember, is if you put it here in the middle and work your way down, it's not building up too much in the middle of your face. And just pat that in. You can use whatever you want. Prefer, you can use a foundation brush, a beauty blender, a beauty sponge, a beauty brush, just whatever works for you. Just don't do your hands. I feel like we all used to do that. Just throw it on with our hands. I didn't do that. Some contour. So, contour stick. It's my usual. My videos, you know I will love this. In fact, that is all I've got left, and I will definitely be going to buy another one because this is just amazing. I just absolutely love it. I'll link everything below as well because I'm really bad at naming everything I use, and we'll wear that every time I'm editing. I'm like, oh, never said what I use, so I'll just link it below. So down our usual places again. If you watch my videos, then it's all pretty similar. The only thing that really changes is my products that I use now and again, and whatever look I'm deciding to do. Something that you like that contour stick, it's just a Rimmel one. If it works for you, then use it, you know, keep getting it. There's no need getting it again. All the drugstore stuff that you get, it's actually amazing. I'll be going with my contour today with a powder. I like it heavy. Another Rimmel. Rimmel, if you want to sponsor me, I use all your products. So this is by Rimmel and it's in Ivory. I think I really should know if I use it enough. So highlight the tip of the nose, up here, a little bit of forehead. All you're doing is highlighting. When it comes to highlighting, you're just highlighting the points that light would naturally hit your face. That's how you blend up 1 minute. I found it. It was literally right in front of me. So flip it around. You've got this on the end here. And starting from the inner corner, blend it out. So much, it's just, I have a mirror. I'm gonna use it. So like I said, I'm gonna bake, so I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to get super close to you. Where you put your contour, this goes underneath. This will help set, if you've concealed, it'll help set that into place, but I find that I just put it here. Not only does it help set my foundation, in a way, if you've got a sweaty face, but it also makes your contour pop more, and hopefully you'll see that. And you just want to leave it for sort of 10 minutes really, which is fine. the set being horrible and nobody wants a crusty face. Taking the lid off already. And I like the shade. I've got a darker one, but I like the light one. So all we're doing is wafting. This is a contour brush, just an angled brush. And then always tap it through. Just bronzing highlighting powder. This is what we're using. You can see my ring light in that. And here's my fan brush. It's Boohoo brush. Lighter. Can you that? A little bit on top of my nose. My eyes on the bridge of my nose. This is such a nice highlighter. The only thing is, you've got to be really careful with it because it's a bronzing highlighter. When you're using it, obviously it can come out quite sort of dark, and if you use too much of it, it can come out patchy, so really a little bit of this goes a long way. This is going to last me a long time. With eyebrows, so I'm going to brush through. Just go in with a little eyebrow comb and just comb them up. They're doing this is it, and it makes your eyebrows look more fluffy. But it also gives you an opportunity to sort of shape your brows before filling them in. And there's a brush on the other end that just use that for the shaping. See, even as waxed, I hate plucking them. I find it so painful, but getting them waxed, I don't know, I kind of enjoy it. I do like getting waxed, but I don't trust myself to do it. Brave enough or stupid enough, I probably end up waxing the whole thing off or something. Okay, and then let's go in to do our brows. I'm going to use the Pixie Brow and Gel Duo. This is it. So as you can probably guess, it's got a pencil at one end, a brow gel at the other. And the good thing about the pencil, what I love about it, is it's angled, so it's actually shaped like an angled brush, so it makes it really easy to get in like fine hairs to draw your strokes in. So I'm actually gonna use my mirror for this. So what you wanna do is start off, again as usual, we're starting off here, halfway down our brow. Start from the middle and not start from here and start filling in, because you will get them too, almost like too, I don't know how to explain it, but like if you think your natural brows, they're much more lighter at the front and then they can worry about any buttons as well. Obviously we've got the other one, gel, a little spoolie, and we brush through the brows. So let's start off the front. So the point of the brow gel is it not only creates a more fluffy eyebrow, because we're all about fluff, while it helps to set that pencil. And do this one. So I'll be back with you in just 2 minutes. Eyebrows. And we're going to just take a little angled brush. Oh, look at the shine on that. And just take a tiny, like legit, a tiny bit. And just tidy them up. So I have to stop doing that with my camera. I'm just covering you up all the time. I've already done this one actually, I did it off camera. So I'd do this one on camera. And then you can just bring it down onto your lid a little bit too. In fact, put on both my lids because the look that we're doing today, it's what I'm all about. I absolutely love using colour when it comes to eyeshadow and eye makeup in general. I love colour. If you want to wear bright green eyeshadow, then wear bright green eyeshadow. If you like it, who cares? So I'm using this. So, eyeshadow palettes. I'm not using obviously all the colours. It's just like different colours out of each one. I think there's one colour in each. These are all W7 palettes. I got these as a pack. These all came together. I'm using this, which is actually a blush. But it's a Technique blush. But when I saw this, I got this with the other two, one that I use and there's a darker brown. I am never wearing that as a blush because it's just too pink, unless we do like a Barbie girl look or something. I don't know, but I would never wear that. And then I've got these two little Technique ones as well. Let me open them to show you. We've got all our palette and this, I think they're all shimmers actually. First, the rest have got a shimmer to them, and we're going in with this shade here. So this is going to be the transition shade and the shade we're keeping at the front of our eye in the inner corner. So this is called Moonlight, and pat that over the lid. Mackenzie, if you're watching this, please stop sending me things when I'm trying to film. He knows I'm filming. I'm just going to use the same brush for the pink. I'm going to take a little bit of pink. Oh, it's very pigmented. It's better to just build up the colour, and I mean you'll see it when it's building up, it'll just obviously get darker. So what I'm doing is I'm putting this just on my lid, we're not taking it up here, and I'm going to create a wing with the shadow, and I crease, and just make it as pink as you like. They're your eyes. Extra, we may as well go out and be super extra. Just learning to read. The W7 Pretty Please Ripe and Red Palette. So again, there's some matte shades in here and there's some shimmers. You can see this one here, if you use a ton of it as you know, in different things. But let's go in with this shade just here. So this is quite a dark pink, so because I want it to be quite bright, I'm not gonna use a lot of it. But what this will do is it'll just make the pink pop a little bit more. So let's zoom you back in and just pat like that. There we go. And then up the wing. Right, can see the difference, just it looks so much more pink, which is, it's what we want. If you're going to put pink eyeshadow on, you know, you want it to look pink. Transition from the colour to another. Let's go in with under eye. So I'm going to use that angled brush I just used. Just put it in this blue. It's almost like a first impression, so I've never used this before. If you decide to give this look a go, don't copy me completely and put yourself in the eye a million times. And then I'm actually going to grab the blue under the pink a little bit like that. Same on the other eye. Shimmers, and we are going to use this colour right here. And then another blending brush, a clean one. Just little tiny circles and just blend it out a little bit. Just a little bit more smoky. And not so clean and sharp. I'm going to go in with another colour, this colour here in the palette, next to that blue. Add a little bit of it into the corner, and this, like I say, it'll just add that little bit of dimension, which honestly makes a big difference. So in the crease here, and just out. I'm just patting it into the inner corner. And I'm actually going to put that shade underneath my lid as well. I have a new business, Instagram and Facebook as well, just while I remember. I have partnered up with FM Sense, and we offer so much beauty related, cleaning related candles. I'm specialising in makeup and skincare. I'm also going to be doing fragrances as well. What I'll do is at the end I'll link my Facebook page and my Instagram page, and if you can go over, check it out. If you can give me a follow and a like, that would be amazing, because I will be having a video coming up in the future, the very near future, doing a full face of FM products, to sort of review and just show you how great they are. Like I said, I'll link that at the end as well with my other Instagram, my personal Instagram. It makes me sad that this is almost out. I mean, I can just go buy another one, but I don't have it now. I need another one. It's really helpful. Okay. Let's go in with some pencil liner. So I'm going to use the Huda Beauty pencil liner and do the bottom waterline, top lash line. Hey, Mara, because it gives you big lashes. That's why it's called Big Lash Mascara. And we're gonna use duo glue, the usual. I use the clear duo glue. I like it. I've not actually used the black one, but the black one apparently is actually better. So I'm going to use lash applicators. These are the Ardell ones, I think. And I'm just going to pass a thin layer of glue on, and I'm just going to leave them set. Do lips quickly. So this is a Technique lip liner in shade unknown, apparently, but it's I don't know if I can do this on my hand. Sort of brown colour. It's coming in, isn't it? Cross at the start, at the top. So start up in this corner, line down, start up in this corner, line down, and then line from there, and that way you get this nice V shape at the top. what I'm gonna do. Oh, sure, these have already been cut to its size. And just place it where you would have it. You can also use your fingers if you don't use a lash applicator, so just put that on. Enjoyed. I will link here my Instagrams somewhere on the screen, my Facebook. If you did enjoy, please subscribe. Like products will be coming too. Give this video a like if you enjoyed. Give me a comment. And yeah, I will see you next time. We'll be right back.